So how do you make DRAM? That was SRAM. Now we want to make DRAM. So DRAM is dynamic random access memory. And instead of using a pair of inverters to do a feedback loop to keep the value, it just uses a capacitor. And you put a plus charge on the capacitor to store 1 and no charge on the capacitor to store 0. So here's a picture of a DRAM circuit. We have our capacitor, which holds the charge, and we have an access transistor, which enables us to access it. The problem with DRAM is the charge dissipates over time. It's not a perfect capacitor. Some of it leaks through the enable transistor, some of it leaks through the circuit itself. And so over time, the capacitor discharges, which means your data disappears. So what this means is that the DRAM has to be periodically refreshed. So every so often, the computer has to read through all of its memory and update the values. So read the old values and write new values to get new charge in there. Further, when you read from the capacitor, you take all of the charge out of it to read. So that after you read, you destroy the value. So after every read, you have to write back again into the DRAM to put the value back. And this is why it's dynamic. It doesn't stay in one place the way a static one does. It changes over time. But there's a benefit. These are 6 to 10 times smaller than SRAM, which means they're enormously cheaper. And that's why almost all memory today is DRAM, just because it's so much cheaper. Let's take a look at how DRAM is actually built. Here's a picture of a capacitor well. So this is actually a well that goes down into the silicon. Here's the top of the silicon chip, and it's been etched out to go down. And you can see these edges here. This is the edge of the capacitor. What determines how high a capacitance something has is what's its surface area. So by going down deep like this, they can increase the capacitance and therefore store more charge, so they need to refresh less often. Here's another picture of capacitors. And here you can see the capacitors going down. You can see the access transistors up here, and then you can see the wires that connect them up to the rest of the chip. Here's a schematic picture of it showing you how deep the transistor is compared to the size of the access transistor. So let's talk a little bit about memory speeds. Why are DRAMs slow and SRAMs fast? And the reason for this is all about the time it takes to get the output. And so what does it mean to get the output? Well, if there's a 1 or 0 in the memory cell, it means how long does it take to get that 1 or 0 out on the wire that comes out of the memory to the output. So let's take a look at what our memories look like. We have all these cells, and they have a long wire connecting them together. For SRAM, these cells are these little powered inverters connected to that. And for DRAM, the cells are teeny little capacitors connected to that. So in the SRAM case, we have these inverters. And remember, the inverters are hooked up to power, so they can drive out onto that wire, and they can use the power supply to drive a lot of charge onto the wire. So they can change the value of that output pretty quickly. DRAM, however, doesn't have any power. All it has is whatever charge you've stored on that capacitor. So this is a teeny little capacitor hooked up to a really long wire, and it's slow. So this is very slow. You've got a teeny capacitor trying to charge up a large wire, and it's going to take a long time. So SRAMs have a powered inverter driving their output, and DRAMs have only whatever charge is left in the capacitor driving their output, and this is why one of them is fast and the other slow. It also explains why they're cheap and expensive. So DRAMs are much smaller. You don't have to run power wires to them. You only have to make one transistor and one capacitor. SRAMs need a total of 6 transistors in order to build that, plus they need the power lines. So they're much larger, which makes them more expensive. So let's summarize what we said about memories. SRAM is static, and it keeps the value with an active feedback loop. So it needs power and ground, and it's much bigger, but it's faster. DRAM is dynamic memory, keeps the value as charge on the capacitor, which means it's going to be much slower, but can also be smaller. So SRAM is big and fast, and DRAM is small and slow. We looked at how you could build latches from SRAM cells, and we looked at two types. We looked at transparent latches, where the input goes right through to the output, and we looked at master-slave, or D, flip-flops, which only update the output on the rising clock edge.